welcome, and I'd like to introduce a range of items and a range of manifestations of those items that we can consider. Most importantly, I'd like to introduce the concepts that we'll be moving forward with and dealing with and considering. Ultimately, there are potentially between 1 and 5 key conference components that we want to talk about, that we want to move forward with and explore. That's, to a certain extent, the key, maybe paradox that we're looking at today, explore. So, what we're exploring is, in more detail, is we're taking ideas from one pedagogical structure to the second and third dimension of that pedagogical structure. So, to give you an example, let's take it forward, let's consider momentum, let's consider momentum within the context of ubiquitous learning. Ubiquitous learning. I want to explore and I want to push the concept so that we consider it in more detail. Let's push the concept. Let's move the ideas forward. Let's consider equality within the context of democratic structure that pushes knowledge from one dimension to the next. Allowing all stakeholders to reach. So, let's consider again pedagogical structures, andragogical structures, knowledge, learning, and space. This session looks at primarily 4 pedagogical structures and how these structures can be tilted, shifted, shaped, and formed and reformed to consider in positions that are beyond stakeholders' knowledge. That said, what I really want to do is to discuss the 4 pedagogical shapes and the 4 structures that suggest learning has taken place. Learning in a position and time zone that is beyond comfortable. So, we're looking at shapes that ultimately fit and don't fit, ultimately prepare and are unprepared, and are ultimately challenged and then re-challenged. But shapes in themselves, as symbolic structures representing form, knowledge, learning, and to a certain extent, paradoxical positioning, these four structures will enable learning within a deep core context, within a deep core context that allows you to shift, form, transform, transition. Excuse me. So looking at that, taking that as a form and repositioning it, redistributing it, re-presenting it, and exploring the dynamic between each 4 allows us to make that shift, to make that uncomfortable / comfortable transition into knowledge forming, allowing that to then sliver filter into the presentation that allows visual stimulus to shift and form and morph, primarily morphing. Morphing, morphing, allowing shapes to morph and not continue to live in exactly the same context, but instead shift and change. I'm not interested in how these forms are identical and how these forms take the same shape symbolically. I'm not interested in that. What we need to consider it, and what we need to consider in a kind of locality and a quality of trust, but also to take that shape forward, is to re-acknowledge them as learning objects. Not barriers. Not barriers. These are not barriers, 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 but instead they will allow us to take the next steps, to take the next steps. From that point to this point, considering and reconsidering, positioning and repositioning, to the point where pedagogical structures are learning whilst we learn simultaneous learning. Simultaneous learning. Blended. Blended. E-learning will not allow this shift to take place. E-learning is just a primal focus, a primordial focus. This is beyond e-learning in an exceptional way. Beyond e-learning in an exceptional way. To conclude, this symbolic board structure that represents pedagogical ABCD strata is beyond e-learning, beyond blended learning, beyond the current faculty of learning. It will take us to a new level, new, deeper, more sophisticated level that will complexify each and every one of us. Each and every stakeholder, pedagogical investor, if you're invested in pedagogy, you're invested in symbolic shapes and forms that push your learning, stretch your learning, challenge, punch, violently readjust to the new way of thinking. Ultimately, there are 10 sessions. These sessions will slowly edge you off the precipice into a zone of enlightened pedagogical thinking. Zone of enlightened pedagogical thinking.